G'day guys, it is Joel here again, and today we're talking about creating a 3D LUT for your camera. There's many reasons why you would do this. Some cameras have the ability to have LUTs inside them, so you can preview those LUTs on set and they help you make decisions and get your set in. I suppose if you create a look to run on your camera, it helps with your lighting decisions to keep that look throughout your film. Today, we are setting up a podcast suite at Tommy Rock Studios, and we have a bunch of cameras running into a vision mixer, and two of the cameras allow internal color correction, which is fantastic, but our third camera doesn't allow internal color correction. So we're going to use the same process of creating a LUT to that you would put in your camera on set, but instead of putting it on our camera, we're going to put it into a Blackmagic Designs microconverter. This is the bidirectional 12G microconverter, and it allows us to put in, is it 33 point? I'm pretty sure it's 33 point LUTs. Does it say? Doesn't say on the box. Pretty sure it's 33 point LUTs that this allows you to load into there. But the process of creating a LUT for your camera or for this box or any other 3D LUT box or device that accepts 3D LUTs is going to be the same. So first off is this camera is the Blackmagic Micro Cinema camera, and it's been around for quite a while now. They have replaced it, like they've brought in broadcast versions, 4K broadcast versions, which is what we have over on the other side, and they work with the inbuilt color correction. However, the Micro Cinema camera doesn't have the ability for inbuilt color correction. So we're going to run this in line, the HDMI output, to correct the colors to the other cameras before it comes to our vision switcher. So to do this, we're going to first record with the cameras and the raw format that the camera is sending out. We're going to capture a recording of that so we can take that into DaVinci Resolve, color correct it, and then create a 3D lookup table that we can load in this to correct those colors. So first, we're going to hit record, and I'm just going to switch between the cameras so I have some references there. So as you can see between these two cameras, there is a color difference, and that's why we're going to correct it. And stop that. Okay, so we've done a little recording of both the cameras, so the raw format of the micro camera that we wanted to correct, and also a reference shot from our main camera. And now we're going to take that footage and we're going to head up to the color suite and ingest that footage and correct it, and then we'll save out a 33 point LUT. Then we're going to come back down, plug it all in, and see the results. Okay, so now we're in the color suite, and we're going to ingest the footage of the two cameras. We're going to take a reference, a still from the main camera, which is what we're going to match the colors to, and then we're going to correct that. Okay, so here we have, this is the camera we're going to correct, and this is the camera we're going to match. So as you can see, the camera is very, very flat. And we're going to match it to this one. So first we'll take a still so we can swipe. And when we come to this one, we can see our two cameras. Then on our nodes, we're going to use our primaries to correct this camera. And looking at our scopes, we're going to try and get everything very close. There we go. I think that looks pretty close for the purpose of our live streaming and podcast suite there. All right, so we've finished our grade and we're now going to output a 33 point LUT to load onto our LUT box or in our camera. In our color tab, this is the color, the clip we just graded. So we're going to right click on that and you'll see generate LUT. And then you can pick what type of LUT you want to generate. And we're going to generate a 33-point cube for the microconverter. So we'll open that and we will call it Micro Cinema Film, because I know that that's the mode the camera was on and I want to associate that with the dynamic range the camera was set to. We save that and now we can go downstairs, unbox the microconverter, and we will load that LUT into it using a USB-C port on a laptop. So we'll head back downstairs now and do that. Okay, so now we're back in the podcast room and I'm going to get a laptop booted up there. I'll just sit that down there while I get this sorted. We'll unbox this and we'll see what comes in this little box. This looks fun and boring.
Go do the ASMR.
Okay, so now there are two versions of this microconverter you can buy. There's the microconverter itself, which just powers from USB-C and doesn't come with a power supply, so it's slightly cheaper. Or you can buy this version, which comes with a power supply, a power brick with that goes to USB-C. I prefer these because while you can power it from USB-C for a computer or another power supply, you still have to have that availability, and it also restricts where you place your LUT box. So buying the version for a little bit more with the USB-C power brick means you can place it anywhere along the chain. So first things first, we install the software on a computer, which you can download from Blackmagic's website, and that allows you to plug this into your computer using the USB-C cable, and then loading your 3D LUT into this that we just created, and switching it on, whether you want that in the SDI ports or in the HDMI ports. Because the micro is using the HDMI ports, we're going to take the HDMI output of the micro into the input of the box, and then the output of the box will also be HDMI cable back to the switch. That's where a laptop comes into it. Now, one thing that Blackmagic don't seem to supply with it, even though you get a USB power brick, there is no USB-C cable. So I'll borrow a USB-C cable from our hard drive so I can plug it into the laptop, connect to it. I'm not too sure if the version that comes without the power supply comes with a cable or not. I'm assuming it doesn't, but I could be wrong. Here we go. So we're open. We click on this little icon here, and of course it wants to update. More waiting. It's updating. This is the reality of opening up brand new things and going, hey, let me show you guys what we're going to do today and how to do it. And everything we do is like, oh, we're going to download software, we're going to wait. Oh, we're going to install software, we're going to wait. Oh, now there's a firmware update, we have to wait. So we're finished. We should be able to select this button now, which we can. And as you can see here, we can give it a name. And then over here, you'll see LUTs. And when you click on LUTs, this is where you import your LUT. So this is where I'm going to stitch myself up here because I borrowed, the HDMI cable from the hard drive, which the LUT's on. I will now plug the microconverter back in. And in our software, it should detect it. There it is. We can hit this little button. We can go over to our LUTs. And here we're going to import our LUT, which I've placed on the desktop here. So we can go to desktop. Here it is there. And open that. Now it's importing that LUT into the device. Okay. Now, this is how you turn the LUT on and off and what output you actually want it on. For example, if I wanted to send a video signal into the microconverter, but it's only the HDMI output I want this LUT to apply to, I would just highlight HDMI output. And we are using the HDMI output in this instance because we're going HDMI in and HDMI out. But if we also wanted to bring an output from the SDI output, we could also apply to that. But if it's not going to that color correction, we don't want to go to that device. Maybe we want a raw signal coming from that camera to another device to grade later. We would bypass that so it doesn't apply that LUT. It's a very, very handy option. So we're gonna save that and that's it. It's done, it's on. So now we can disconnect this from our computer and put it in line with our Micro Cinema camera. And we're gonna go out of the HDMI output back into the ATM Mini, and then we're going to plug the camera into this. Now we need to power it. Oh my gosh, look at that. So as you can see, all our cameras are color corrected. All right, so that's it. All three cameras now are color matched. So anyone can come in and just use the podcast suite knowing that there's no color correction needing to be done afterwards. This is a really cool little device. We'll leave a link below for you to purchase it. It will be an affiliate link because it helps support what we do here. And you can use this same method of creating a LUT to create looks for your cameras on set, or to create LUTs for LUT boxes like this to correct displays, or for cameras. Catch us in the next one.